My name is Margaret Bransford. I am the Associate Director of Entrepreneurship at St. Olaf College. My role is really there to help students get that one-on-one time and that guidance that they need to build their business idea. You might think that for entrepreneurship, a business school is the way to go, but actually, since I've been here at St. Olaf and witnessed the liberal arts education, I really think that this is where an entrepreneur should be.
Olis make good entrepreneurs for a few reasons. Olis tend to be more open-minded and more accepting of feedback and having an awareness of what's happening around them.
So I think liberal arts education has been instrumental for me in my entrepreneurial journey. Being able to pull in a cross-section of skills. You can't just do it with one type of person or one sort of solution.
One of the things that has really struck me about our students who are interested in entrepreneurship is how passionate they are about their ideas. And often those ideas come with a social component. They want to make an impact not just in the business world, but also socially.
AON vision is to eradicate maternal and infant mortality rate in Sierra Leone by delivering maternal delivery kit in remote areas using drones.
So Panapa is a web application that advertises small businesses in Zimbabwe to increase their customer base, and these businesses would otherwise not have any platform to advertise their services. And it also allows users one centralized place where they can make more informed decisions about the services and products that they use on a day-to-day basis.
Our business venture is Sophia's Pocket. Sophia's Pocket is essentially just fashionable and functional clothing for millennial women. Leslie and Margaret at the Piper Center were fantastic. I personally am not a public speaker. I'm incredibly introverted. I had to practice.
When you look at her, no one could ever think that she was nervous. She was so eloquent. Yeah.
What we do is we work with you on your pitch, and at the Oli Cup pitch competition, you give your presentation to a panel of usually about 10 or 12 judges. These judges are all alumni, and we award funding to the ventures that those judges deem to have the most potential. One thing I was really proud of after Oli Cup this year is that 7 of our 10 ventures that were pitched in Oli Cup are actually moving forward.
I gained a lot of self-confidence from this, and I feel that if I want to do something, even if it's really scary and I don't think I'm going to succeed, I might as well try because, you know, I can do more than I think that I'm capable of a lot of the times.
My advice is if you think you're too small to make a difference, you haven't spent time with a mosquito, because the mosquito is small but can make a lot of difference.
For me, to give some advice to some future entrepreneurs is that to be totally fine with failing and be totally okay with disappointing people, because at the end of the day, you have to learn from those failures. Go ahead and fail quickly, and make sure you learn something from every failure.
If you have an idea, if you have a creative mindset, and you think you have this budding entrepreneur in you, St. Olaf might be the place to take that idea to the next level.